Hello everyone, we were discussing class 9th chapter 8, that is motion. So let us continue, and we are going to discuss some important concepts like speed, average speed, velocity, average velocity, acceleration. Okay, so welcome to another section of Physics Plus YouTube channel. This is Munib Hanifa. Speed. We all are familiar with the word speed, right? We know something about speed. But what is the actual definition for a speed, or how can you define a speed? So let's see one small animated image. So here we can see two cars, okay? And the above one is A and the below one is B, okay? They are starting from a point, a post here, and they are going to reach in that post, okay? So let us start the journey. Okay, fine. So according to your view, which one is having greater speed? Yes, definitely the one which is below, right? B is having greater speed. So how can you define this speed? Here both cars are traveling the same distance between these two posts, right? But their reaching times are different, right? So one which is reaching in a short period, that one we are calling it as having greater speed, right? The one which takes less time, we are calling that one as greater speed. So one thing we are sure, that speed should have a relation with what? Time, right? If the time is short, the second car, it takes very short time to reach that post. So if the time is short, we can say that it is having higher speed, right? So the speed is having some relation, that is inverse relation with the time. Inverse relation means if the time is short, if the time is small, the speed will be high, right? Suppose we are giving these two cars, okay, in a short period of time, and we are asking them to move, and the one which covers larger distance within a short period of time, we can say that the one which is covering the larger distance in short period is having greater speed, right? So speed is related with the distance covered, and speed is related with the time. So the formula for the speed is the distance covered by time. In our cars or bikes, we have seen that, right? Speedometer. The name of that device is speedometer. What does that shows actually? Suppose it is showing like this, okay? What is the meaning of that? What will be the speed of the car? Yes, zero. Why? Because that shows it is having zero speed. That means the car is at rest. Clear? Suppose if we are changing the image into some another image like this, what is the meaning of that? It is showing 40 kilometer per hour. Okay, so what is the unit of the speed? Let me come to that point. What is the unit of the speed? Distance by time. We know that in our first class we have introduced some units for the distance, right? Distance can be measured in terms of meter, kilometer, centimeter, right? So speed, distance, for instance, we are, for the time being, we are taking the distance unit as to be kilometer, okay? And time, suppose I am taking, we can take time in hour, second, minutes, okay? So one of the unit of speed is kilometer per hour, clear? Or it can have meter per second. Kilometer can be changed into meter, hour can be changed into second. These are the units of speed. Okay, so let us come back to the example. This speedometer here shows the arrow indicating at 40 kilometer per hour, because kilometer per hour is mentioned in the speedometer. So what is the meaning of that? What is the meaning of this kilometer per hour indication? Suppose an example. Suppose this is our home. Okay, I'm very good in drawing. This is our home and this is our school. Home and school are almost similar in shape. Okay, and suppose there is a distance of 20 kilometer distance. Okay, there is a 20 kilometer distance. Okay, and you are just about to leave from your home to school. Okay, listen carefully. You are just leaving and you are just having 30 minutes to reach the school. You are having just 30 minutes to start your classes. Okay, it's 20 kilometers, you know, and your father is riding the car. Okay, and he is riding with a speed in the speedometer that is showing 20 kilometer per hour. Okay, are you getting my point? You are in a car that is driven by your father. Okay, that is having a speedometer showing 20 kilometer per hour. So my question is, suppose you are starting from your home at 9:30 and your school starts at 10, whether you will reach the school at 10 a.m. Is it possible? Definitely no. Why? Because when you go in that speed, that is 20 kilometer per hour, that means you will reach the school after 1 hour, right? So you have to increase the speed. Speed means we will cover more distance in a short period of time. So if we go in that speed, that is 20 kilometer per hour, we know that because we are every day we are going to school. So we will ask our father to drive fast, right? So if our speedometer is showing 40 kilometer per hour, then we are happy. Why? Because 40 kilometer per hour means what? We will reach a distance of 40 kilometer in 1 hour. But our distance, our destination is only 20 kilometer. So if we can move a 40 kilometer in 1 hour, we will definitely reach 20 kilometer in 30 minutes. Clear? Is that clear? Because if somebody can drive at a speed 40 kilometer in 1 hour, listen carefully, if we can drive the car in 40 kilometer in 1 hour, so 1 hour means what? So let me write 40 kilometer in 1 hour. 1 hour means 60 minutes. Okay, a 40 kilometer in 60 minutes. So, but our destination is only 20 kilometer. So surely we will reach a 20 kilometer in 30 minutes. Right? So we will ask whoever is driving the car to make it fast. Fast means what we are actually telling is we have to be a little more speed. Okay, so is the concept of speed clear? Next point is uniform speed. The word is having its meaning. Uniform speed means what? Speed should be uniform. What is the meaning of that? Speed should be uniform means uniform speed. Right. So let us see what is this uniform speed. Suppose we are starting from here and I am dividing this into different points A, B, C and D. Okay. Suppose every points are of equal distance 2 meter with respect to each other. Okay. So suppose we are starting our journey from here and we are moving on to A, B, C and D. Okay. So we are taking from A 0 to A 2 seconds. We are reaching from 0 to A in 2 seconds and from A to B it is 2 seconds and B to C again it is 2 seconds and we are reaching from C to D again it is taking 2 seconds. So what is the significance of this journey? See, we can say that we are covering equal distance, 2 meter, 2 meter, 2 meter, 2 meter, equal distance in what time? Equal interval of time. Or we can say in another format, uniform speed is, what is the speed of 0 to A? Speed of 0 to A, speed of the car in 0 to A. We know the relation, speed is nothing but distance by time. What is the distance here? Distance is 2 meter. What is the time here? 2 second. So what is 2 by 2? That is 1 meter per second is the speed of car from 0 to A. Clear? What is the speed from A to B? You can see that from A to B, the distance is again 2 meter and the time is again 2 seconds. So 2 by 2, 1 meter. Here it is also 1 meter per second. Here it is also 1 meter per second. So what my point is, this is what we call as uniform speed. So you have to keep two things in mind. What is a uniform speed means? We are covering equal distance, 2 meter, 2 meter, 2 meter, in equal interval of time, 2 second, 2 second, 2 second. Okay. So equal distance in, equal distance in equal interval of time. That is our uniform speed. Or we can say that the speed, the value of the speed is always 1 meter per second, 1 meter per second, 1 meter per second, 1 meter per second. What is the meaning of that? Speed is constant. Speed is constant. Constant means the value of the speed is not going to change. Okay. So what will be a non-uniform speed? We're just changing this into a non-uniform speed. Just the reverse of this, right? Suppose this is 2 meter and we are covering this in 1 second, this in 2 second, this in 3 second and this in 4 second. Okay, now it become what? Non-uniform speed. How? Because this 2 second, 2 meter is taking 1 second. The next 2 meter the car is taking 2 second. The next 2 meter the car is taking 3 second. That means the value of the speed here is what? Here this value of the speed is 2 divided by 1. That is what? 2 meter per second. Right? In the second one, A to B, the value of the speed is 2 divided by 2. What is that? 1 meter per second. Here it is 2 divided by 3. That is the speed. In every case, the speed is changing. Okay, clear. So here in non-uniform, the speed is not constant, or we can never say that it is covering equal interval in equal distance of time. Sorry, it is not covering equal distance in equal interval of time. Okay, so the concept of uniform and the non-uniform speed, clear? The next important concept is velocity. Velocity. Okay, let us see one small animated picture. Suppose we are having four cars. Suppose we are having a car which is moving in a uniform speed. Okay, we know what is the uniform speed, right? Uniform speed of 40 kilometer per hour. Okay, uniform speed of 40 kilometer per hour. Okay, but the direction of the four cars are different. Okay, so what is the meaning of 40 kilometer per hour? That means in 1 hour, our car will reach a distance of 40 kilometer. Okay, so clear. So in north, I'm having person A standing. In west, I'm having person B standing. In south, I'm having person C standing. And in east, I am having person D is standing. Okay. So, if we are just giving the car a 40 kilometer per hour, we can see what is happening here. Okay, just start. What we have seen is, in the four cases, the speed is 40 kilometer per hour, but the one reaches at A, the another car reached at B, and the third one reached at C, and the fourth one reached at D. That means their result is different. That depends on in which direction they are moving, right? So we are framing the speed plus direction into another term. That is what we call as velocity. Okay, clear? So velocity is nothing but speed, but with a particular direction, because we can say that the velocity of all the cars are different. Let me repeat, the velocity of all the cars are different, but the speed of every car are same. Clear? The velocity different. Why? Because the direction is different for all that. But the value of the speed, the value, the magnitude of the speed is same, but the velocity is different. So we can say velocity is nothing but the value of speed plus direction. Okay, the concept of velocity is speed, which is having certain direction. So what will be the SI unit of velocity? Direction is not having any unit, right? So SI unit of velocity is same as meter per second, same as speed, or kilometer per hour, or what all units it is having, speed. Okay, clear? Now the concept is clear for the velocity. So what is the main difference between the speed and velocity? Speed, we know, speed is distance covered by time. That means distance is a scalar quantity. We have studied it in our first class, what is a scalar quantity, and time is also a scalar. That means speed is a scalar quantity. Scalar means it is just having only number or any value or any magnitude. Okay, but velocity we can write, it is not just a distance, it is distance plus direction, right? It is this whole term, that is speed plus direction. If some distance is having certain direction, we will call that distance as displacement. Am I right? So displacement by time, because it is having certain direction of motion. Or we can say that displacement is not a scalar quantity. Displacement, we have studied it in our first class, that is a vector quantity. Clear? Vector is those which is having the magnitude and direction. Is the concept of speed and velocity clear? Next one is average speed. Okay, very important concept, average speed. Let's see what is this average speed. Suppose we are having a car which is moving from this end to this end, O to O dash, and in between it is covering certain distance points A, B, C. We can call it as 2 meter, 3 meter, 7 meter distance from this to here. Here from here to here it is only 4 meter. Okay, clear? And from O to A, it is taking 1 second to reach. From A to B, it is taking 2 seconds to reach. From B to C, it is taking 3 seconds to reach. From C to D, it is taking 4 seconds. So one thing it is sure, this is not a uniform motion, right? Because speed is not constant, 2 by 1, 2, that is a speed here, right? 3 by 2, distance by time, that is the speed here. So we can see it is a non-uniform motion, but it is having certain speed. Distance by time, we got one speed. Distance by time, we get another speed. Distance by time, we get another speed. That means the speed is changing. So we are introducing a new value, average speed. Okay, so the formula for the average speed is total distance. Suppose this distance I am calling it as S1, and this distance I am calling it as S2, this distance I am calling it as S3, and this distance I am calling it as S4. Okay, this distance. Okay, clear. So average speed is total distance formula, total distance by total time. Okay, so what is the total distance here? S1 plus S2 plus S3 plus S4 divided by total time. Suppose I am naming this time as T1, this time as T2, this time as T3, and this as T4. So what is the total time? T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4. This is a general formula for average speed. Okay, total distance, sum of the total distance by sum of the total time taken. We have seen what is this average speed, right? So what is the next one is average velocity. What is this average velocity? We know what is the difference between speed and velocity, right? So one definition for average velocity is what was the average speed, total distance by total time taken. So what will be the average velocity? Total, instead of distance, we will be having total displacement by total time. Okay, clear. One more formula is there for velocity. If our car or whatever the body which is moving is moving at a constant speed or velocity in two different velocity, one is u at a particular time, okay, and after some time it starts moving with another velocity that is constant, which is having a value v. Okay, so this is the first velocity, which is constant for some time, and this is the another velocity, which is again constant for some particular duration. In that case, what will be the average velocity? In that case, the average velocity will be initial velocity. Suppose this is the initial and this is the final. So initial plus final velocity divided by 2. This is another formula for the average velocity. So for the average velocity, we were having two formulas. One is total displacement by total time taken, and the another one is initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. Okay, is the concept clear? So from all this discussion, we can conclude these points. That is the difference between speed and velocity. Speed is nothing but total distance covered per unit time. We have discussed the formula. And the velocity is, instead of distance, we are having displacement, because velocity we have said that it is speed plus direction, so it is the total displacement of the body per unit time. Okay, definitely this will be a scalar quantity. Why? Because distance is a scalar quantity. Okay, it is only having value, speed is only having value. Velocity, obviously it is a vector quantity. Why? Because displacement is a vector quantity. Okay, clear. But both are having the units, same units, meter per second, kilometer per hour. Okay, average speed can never be zero. Average speed of the body will never be zero. Why? Because if a body is traveling from one point to another point, it must have covered certain distance. So distance is not zero, so average speed will be never will be zero. Okay, but average velocity can have zero value. Why? Because displacement can have zero value. If you are starting from one point and moving on to the another point and returning back to the same point, we have discussed similar problem in our first class. Okay, so those who haven't seen that class, please kindly see that class. Okay, in that class we have discussed, if we are coming back to the initial point, then our displacement will be zero. If the displacement is zero, the average velocity will be zero. That is, it depends upon the displacement. Okay, hope the concept of speed, velocity, average speed, average velocity is clear. Okay, so moving on to the next session, let's come to the next topic, that is acceleration. What is acceleration? Suppose let's see that race once again. We were having two cars, right? And suppose they are starting from this post and it's starting. Initially we can see that both are moving in the same speed, right? But when it finishes, the second car increased its speed, right? Then only it came to the first. increase its speed means, and it is moving with a direction, so we can say it increase its velocity. Why velocity? Speed plus direction is velocity. So the second car increase its velocity, or we can say in another term, the second car accelerated. Clear? So what is acceleration? Acceleration means change, rate of change, rate of change of velocity. Okay, rate of change of velocity. We know what is the rate. Rate means what? With respect to time, right? Change of velocity. What is the meaning of change of velocity? Suppose our body is moving initially with a velocity, initial velocity u. Okay, after some time it has changed its velocity to v. V is the final velocity in a time interval t. So what is the acceleration here? Acceleration here is change of velocity. What is the change? Final minus initial. That is how we calculate the change, right? So final minus initial by time. So this is our acceleration formula. Okay, clear? So acceleration is nothing but the rate of change of velocity. Clear? So what will be the SI unit of acceleration? What is here? What is the SI unit of velocity? SI unit of velocity, we already studied, that is meter per second, right? Again, there is a time here, by second. So how many seconds are there in the denominator? Meter per second square. This is the SI unit of acceleration. Clear? Suppose, let me give you an example. Suppose our car is initially moving with a velocity 2 meters per second, and finally after 1 second its velocity changes to 5 meters per second. Okay, we need to calculate the acceleration. So what will be the acceleration here? Acceleration is final minus initial, that is 5 minus 2 by time. What is time? 1 second. What is the answer? 3 meters per second square. Okay, this much acceleration is having this body. Suppose I am reversing the case. The initial velocity, suppose I am assuming, if the initial velocity is 5 and the final velocity, okay, very careful, it is 2 now. Initial velocity is 5 and the final velocity is 2 meters per second. What is the acceleration here? Acceleration here, it will be final. What is the final value? 2 minus 5 divided by 1. What is the answer? 2 minus 5. What is that? It is not 3. It is minus 3. What is the meaning of whether there is any difference between plus 3 meter per second and minus 3 meter per second? Yes. In the starting case, the body was increasing its speed, or we can say it is acceleration motion. In the second case, the 5 is changes to 2. That means the acceleration is negative. Acceleration negative means retardation, new word, retardation, or we can say deceleration. Deceleration. Okay, retardation means acceleration will be negative. Okay, so when some questions come, a driver applies the brake. Okay, suppose a body is moving with a velocity 5 kilometers per hour, or it changes to, after applying the brake, it changes to 3 kilometers per second. Okay, so what is acceleration? 5 changes to 3. Definitely the answer will come out to be in negative. Why? Because the final value is lesser as compared to the initial value, so we will get a negative value. Don't worry, acceleration can have positive value and negative value. Negative value means it is a decelerated motion or a retarded motion. Okay, is the concept of acceleration clear? One more point. Suppose if there is no change in the velocity, no change in the velocity means uniform motion, the velocity constant, what will be the acceleration in that case? If the velocity, suppose the question is like this, initial velocity is 5 and the final velocity is also 5, what will be the acceleration? acceleration. Here it will be 5 minus 5, that is 0. So underline, if the velocity is constant, if the velocity is constant, acceleration will be 0. That means for a velocity constant means what? Uniform motion. Right, velocity constant means a uniform motion, our acceleration will be 0. That means there is no change in the acceleration. Okay, is the concept of acceleration clear? Okay, here we conclude our class. We will do some numericals and conceptual study of graphical motion in our coming classes. So keep updated. Thank you so much. This is Munib Hanifa.